okay, well, that's happening.
Kevin can recognize Dan's laugh.
Well, just by, like, sound waves?
Yeah. When did they say that? They said it in one of the recent episodes of something.
Oh, yeah?
Either Portal or Mario Maker.
But yeah. I don't know how that came up, but he just did. Because apparently Dan's laugh is, like, always the same.
Yeah.
And it's the point where Kevin recognizes just by the the sound wave thing.
Oh, welcome to the podcast.
I'm starting?
We're starting? I mean, yeah, that's a pretty... That was a... You were just like, oh, dude, Kevin could fucking recognize Dan's laugh.
Yeah.
Hello, everybody.
What?
Hello, everybody. Welcome to the podcast. No one gave a crap about Thais.
And I'm Alex.
Hey, look at that. You said it.
Shut the fuck up.
Nick, we won't fuck sing. So, yeah, that kind of reminds me of the...
Oh.
We went back online.
Okay.
My Xbox is just, like, freaking out because I think my dad reset the router. But that's besides the point. That reminds me of a thing. I was in my computer science class today, and we were, like, programming. Like, we're learning about loops and stuff. But it was actually before that.
Okay, yes, I'm listening.
But we were converting.
Half a second. Okay, go.
We were converting words into their Latin forms, which is taking the first letter, putting it at the end, and then adding the suffix A-Y.
So, pig Latin? Wait.
Yeah, it's pig Latin.
Right.
So, like, it was, like, you had to give it, like, an input, like, it was raw input. And so I was, like, and he put yo, dot, 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 give me a word, exclamation point. And I'm, like, can you put, like, two more ellipses in there? Because like, I just wanted to be, like, yo, give me a word. I just wanted that, like, long, awkward pause.
Nice.
Yeah.
Yo, give me a word.
So, we have many of topics.
What the fuck?
Let me fucking just mute it. Just mute it. There we go. But, we have many of topics to talk about tonight.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
You got them. I didn't get the memo.
I guess we should talk about Sun and Moon first.
Is the game... There's no information further than that.
It's coming out this year.
Oh, yeah.
Okay. Which everyone thought the next game would be Y. You know, I'm sorry, not YZ.
I was like, it exists, bro.
I have it.
Dude, what... Are you from the past?
Fucking jump out the window. Shady's on! Fucking three of me pop out, like, bust through the door with, like, machine guns.
Holy shit.
The fucking Society of Matthiases instead of the Society of Ricks.
Yep.
And you're my Morty. You're only around to...
No, I'm definitely smarter than you.
Oh, yeah, no. What was that book you were telling me about earlier? How many pages did you have to read on that?
172. From zero.
Oh. Fucking with the microphone there. But, what are, like, some things you want?
But.
Did you see that thing today on iFunny? It's like the Pink Panther's to-do list. It was to-do.
I haven't seen that.
It was pretty great. I have two things on my Xbox. Whatever. It said plus two, and I don't know why. So what are, like, some things you want out of Sun and Moon?
A good game.
A good game? I mean, yeah. They did good with Omega Ruby.
Right. Omega Ruby is, like, my top game right now out of the Pokemon.
Oh, really?
Games.
I need to finish it. I really just need to.
Because I really loved, like, the you can use, like, Latios or Latias to, like, fly over the map.
Mm-hmm.
That was fucking awesome.
Yeah.
And it's also, like, that system implicates a bunch of legendaries at certain, like, times of the day and stuff.
Oh, yeah?
And, like, oh, it's so good.
There's the end game with the space Pokemon. I forget his name.
Deoxys?
Deoxys, yes.
Deoxys and Rayquaza, and you get your Mega Rayquaza, and you're like, this game's so fucking amazing!
Is there a Mega Deoxys?
Don't know. Also, I really want to look at some more Mega Evolutions.
That'd be cool.
More of that.
Pikachu Mega Evolution. Does anyone fucking evolve their Pikachu to Raichu? I've never heard, like... half the people I ask is like, do you ever evolve to Raichu? And they'll be like, who the fuck's Raichu? I mean, the, really? not real, for, but I feel like that would be a thing.
I always have.
Oh, really?
But I don't often train Pikachu.
Yeah.
Just because...
Because it's just like, I never done it. Because like, one, I can find a Thunderstone.
I know I have... I don't remember what game or games, but if I have a Pikachu and I happen to have a Thunderstone for whatever reason, mm-hmm. I do it.
Yeah.
But that's it.
The cool thing is they just released Red, Blue, and Yellow to the eShop on the DS.
Holy shit, I almost died. Down the wrong pipe there. Oh my god. It burned. And then I stopped breathing for a second. And I was like, oh shit, I'm gonna die. I tried really hard not to spit it out, and I forced myself to swallow what was left. It was so painful. What are you talking about?
Since they released Blue, Red, and Yellow to the eShop on the 3DS, you can import those Pokemon to Sun and Moon.
Right.
Using the Pokebank, that thing you have to pay for.
Somebody should fix that.
The thing I did, I waited, everyone had a free, like, 30-day trial.
Right.
So I waited. I bought a hacked version of Pokemon Black 2.
Right.
And I'm like, oh, all the legendaries I want, I'm gonna fucking transfer them. Yeah. My free 30-day.
I did basically the same thing, but I had an action replay, so I didn't
need to. Yeah, mine just came with, like, every single, like, legendary. It was shiny, too. Like, all of them were shiny.
But I did almost the same thing.
Yeah.
And now, Pokemon Bank, fuck it, can't do it.
Man, I still love that one tweet, I told you about it earlier, where it's like, how the Pokemon trailer is like, you can play Pokemon in 9 different languages, and then they tweeted that out, and somebody tweeted back, you forgot the gameplay, though.
Right.
Yeah, they just show concept art, and that's about it.
Because it's like, actually, I think I'd like to see a new region.
Yeah?
Yeah.
I was going to say, would you want to see a new legendary?
No, probably. I would kind of expect it.
Yeah.
Sun and Moon. Well, we already have two Pokemon that are based on the Sun and Moon.
We do.
Hmm.
I wonder if they'll play like a big part.
Maybe they're special for some reason.
Yeah.
They combine.
They combine. I mean, isn't the Moon one a crescent?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
But and then the other one is like...
Cool.
He's a circle and he's got a bunch of spikes coming off.
Yeah. I feel that can the moon one evolve into a full moon? Or is he just stuck in a crescent form?
No idea. I've never seen an evolution of either of them, I don't think.
Hold on. Moon.
I don't even remember what their names are. Solarok sounds like something. Lunatone.
What is this?
And the other one's Solarok or something, right? That sounds right.
Lunatone.
Yeah, that's the moon bitch.
And then Cresselia?
Well, that's this legendary here.
Oh, okay. I don't fucking know. Whatever, but, it'd be interesting. I would like to see a new legendary. I think so far they've been introducing a legendary of every Pokemon iteration. I can't really think of...
Yeah.
Can't really think of one where they haven't.
Well, because usually that's like where the story
revolves around.
Mm-hmm.
Huh. Which so the thing about Pokemon that kind of like, I mean, like it's weird because like they always release two versions,
right?
And like I wonder if they'll ever just do like a Pokemon game where they release one, because everyone thought like that's probably what Z is gonna be.
Hmm.
It's just like a standalone. It's not gonna have anything coming out with it,
because
it's like.
Well, the first with Omega Ruby, and
Alpha Sapphire.
Yes, they had like kind of an explanation.
Yeah.
In it,
because
The meteor or whatever that's coming towards it, they were like, they wanted to open like a. Something to, like, just send it somewhere else, basically. Mm-hmm. Some kind of portal or black hole or something. And they were like, you know, it could go to an alternate universe where they have the same problem. And I'm like, oh, you mean the other game?
That's cool. But, Yeah, because it's always like, the thing, I think my biggest problem was in X and Y, where some Megastones were in like one version of the game.
Oh yeah, those Megastones were fucking in the other. Dumb. Just like, you got your...
Especially because I bought Y, and then X had the Tyranitar's Megastone, and I'm like, fuck. So I had to use my Gamefly account to rent it and just like get all the Megastones and transfer it over.
Hey, it's so stupid. It's like, you want fucking Tyranitar? Ha! Bitch, please.
Do you think...
And okay. Then there's the different versions, like you got Megastone X and Megastone Y for like Mewtwo.
Yeah, Mewtwo, Charizard. I think those are the only two.
Are they? Maybe, I don't
think
know.
So.
Those are the ones I can think of.
And then I thought that like Y had the better... I mean X had the better like exclusive Mega Evolutions because Charizard turned the like gray-blue dude.
Yep.
And then Mewtwo got like a lot bulkier.
Yeah, because then the other ones are Charizard looks almost the same ish.
Yeah,
and then Mewtwo looks like a little bitch.
He's like floating, and he's got that like ring on his head, and then yeah. Like his tail comes out of the back of his head.
I'd be like, oh, is that Mew's Mega Evolution?
Yeah, I mean exactly. I mean, but I don't know. It's weird. Okay, so do you think they would release Pokemon Go along with Sun and Moon?
Along with?
Or, you know, within the same range?
I'd like them to.
Yeah.
But I don't know. I don't see them actually doing it.
If they were smart, they would release Pokemon Go in the spring. Because it's mm-hmm. warmer. Everyone's like actually wants to go outside.
Yeah.
Except, like, dead of winter. Because I tried playing Ingress just to see, like, what Pokemon Go would be like. But it was way too fucking cold for me to go anywhere, like, for me feeling like going anywhere. And I don't have a car or anything. So, if they were smart, they would do it, like, so, like late spring, early summer.
I was just thinking about what are those things that you can get with Pokemon Go.
The wrist thing?
Wrist things. I think they have a name, I don't know.
Probably.
I was just thinking, like... What if it was so big that it, like, changed our society? So, people were, like, picked on for not having it. And they were like, well, you fucking pleb, you don't even have the wrist thing. Get out of here.
Oh, shit. Okay, I also thought of something else as well. We also have Detective Pikachu coming. I mean, it's true. I fucking love that Danny DeVito dub. If you haven't seen the Danny DeVito dub of Detective Pikachu, go watch it.
That was great.
I don't know. I like detective games. That's why I like Danganronpa so much.
But I don't get it. It's weird. It's really weird.
It kind of is.
It's super weird. Because
it's like you're Pikachu and you can like hear your inner thoughts and it's like a human voice. Not the Pika Pika!
It doesn't work at all.
Pikachu!
The voice...
I do shitty Pikachu voice.
The voice just doesn't work for me whatsoever.
Well, we haven't heard an English dub of it yet.
I know.
Fucking Danny DeVito, English dub of Pikachu.
Oh, God. It would make it playable for me. That's kind of the thing, though.
Man. Oh, that'd be great.
Garbage man, like the garbage!
But, oh... That would... Because I don't think Detective Pikachu has a release date at all.
No, I don't think so.
I'm gonna Google something real quick.
I'm gonna Google some more shit.
We've got a laptop here for a reason, Alex.
What are you Googling?
When Danganronpa 3 is supposed to come out.
Yeah, because, you know, just random shit I gotta Google is super of utmost importance. I can't just make a note and do it later. Gotta do it on this time now when we're doing other shit. You are something else, you know that?
You are
something else.
No, there's never, like, no news about Danganronpa 3. It's always like Danganronpa 3 2016 along with the new anime, and there's no like Danganronpa 3 is coming to the US. Like, I'm sure it's gonna come to the US because all the other games did, but I'm like, I weren't like confirmed. I
shut
like...
up and wait. Swear to God. Such a bitch sometimes.
Okay, let me actually look up Detective Pikachu.
Yeah, okay. See, I thought you were gonna look up that, and then you were like, look up Danganronpa.
What the fuck? Danganronpa's on Steam, support it.
I haven't bought it yet, I should.
You should. Nope, I don't see a release date.
He's got a little... What the fuck? Look at that picture.
The internet loves Detective Pikachu.
Do they?
And Detective Pikachu loves you.
Are you sure they don't like the
dude, you're Wars? Somebody who doesn't like Star Wars Battlefront.
I don't. Not the new one.
So, I gotta fart, but I'm gonna keep it in.
I don't like the new Battlefront.
It's okay. A few it's older okay.
Battlefronts that I like.
It's okay. I had somebody say that they didn't like something that like got to me more. I know somebody who didn't like Negasonic Teenage Warhead or Colossus in Deadpool.
They can go fucking die. Right, you know what? I'll kill them. Give me anything, really. I can murder people.
She's like, I didn't like him. Even though that's like the best Colossus like we've ever had in an X-Men movie.
Yeah, it's fucking Colossus. He's Colossus. Fucking, yeah.
So, something I don't understand. So, I guess I kind of understand it, thinking about it. But in the comics, they won't allow Deadpool to join the X-Men because he's not a mutant.
Mm-hmm.
But, like... I guess a mutant in that world is just, like... Fucking, born with it?
Mm-hmm.
Because, like, he is... Like, he got mutated. Like, right. I would say he's a mutant.
Well, because I know that it threw me off when I saw the movie... That it in comics, Deadpool was always trying to be part of the X-Men.
Yeah.
And then in the movie, he was like, no. And, like, Colossus was like, you should join us. And Deadpool was like, no. I was like, whoa, wait, what? That's not what I know.
Well, the only thing that's, like, that I can really think of is because Days of Future Past. And I don't... I'm not sure if Fox knows where the fuck the Marvel Universe... Like, where this takes place in the X-Men universe.
Mm-hmm.
That's why they don't call whatever how Deadpool turns into Deadpool Weapon X, because in the comics it is the Weapon X program that turns him into Deadpool. Because right. I think it's just that Fox has like no clue what the fuck is going on in X-Men right now.
Right. Well, see, that's why I'm really hoping for Apocalypse to be like as good as Days of Future Past or better.
Well, the thing is that. Cable in the comics, if I remember correctly, kills Apocalypse. So, like, that would be kind of cool if they introduced Cable. Like, it would be. I wish they would, like, introduce Cable in Apocalypse, you know what I mean?
Didn't have to be. Doesn't seem like that would work out.
I know, but, like, it'd be cool.
I know, Marvel fucking gave their rights away.
Yeah.
Fucking bitches.
Well, no, they would have the rights to, Cable.
Mm-hmm.
Because he's a mutant.
Mm-hmm.
Part of the X-Men property.
Mm-hmm.
So they could do that.
Mm-hmm.
Fucking... I would love to see Deadpool in the Avengers. Because, I mean, like... Oh, it'd be so great.
Yeah, it would. It would be awesome.
Yeah, that's just Deadpool and everything. Fucking... I pull a fucking random movie off my shelf and be like,
Deadpool. See, but here's the thing. When you put Deadpool in the Avengers, it goes from Avengers... to being a Deadpool movie.
I guess. Well, that was the thing that somebody brought up. When they do, like, an X-Force movie, if they ever get around to it,
mm-hmm.
it'd be cool to make that PG-13 and have Deadpool aware that it's a PG-13 movie. Because, like, the thing is, it's like, yeah, Deadpool's a rated R movie, and he's within his own universe, but when you bring Deadpool into something else, that's, like, it's PG-13, he's aware that, like, he's not in the place he should be, like... Make references to that. He wants to curse, but he can't, you know?
That'd be awesome.
Like, because he would be aware of that. Be like, why can't I curse? Like... and something else that I would kind of like to see, but I don't know how, like, they would transfer well into the movies, is, Deadpool's two voices that he has. Because one is, like, his inner thoughts. At least to my knowledge, that's what he is. And then, like, his more sensible voice that's in the white text boxes in the comics is a villain called Mad Katz. Because, if I remember correctly, Deadpool and Mad Katz were together, and somebody showed up. I think it was Captain America, and Deadpool started fighting Captain America. Mm-hmm. And then Thor shows up out of nowhere.
I'm Thor!
Yeah, pretty much. And kills both, like, smites Mad Katz and Deadpool to the point where they're just, like, ashes. But their ashes come together, and so when Deadpool regenerates, like, Mad Katz is stuck in his head because Mad Katz also has a healing factor.
Wow.
And then the way that they separate them, they have Thor and Luke Cage pull them in half. This is, like, way later. Have them, like, pull in half, and, like, one side becomes Deadpool and the other side becomes Mad Cats.
Alrighty, then.
Pretty interesting.
I saw a Photoshop picture that was done really well of Deadpool handing Thor his hammer.
Yeah, oh yeah.
And I was like, this would totally work because he could totally be aware that it's just a fucking prop.
I mean, yeah. Oh, I saw this really one cool thing. There's this YouTuber. He made an actual hammer, and he would go to Comic-Con, and he would... Oh, you know, no, you motherfucker.
He said, hey, guys, what you doing?
Hold on.
Oh, fucking hell. Okay, so, something about Cameron.
Oh, God. let me move this. There we go.
Don't. There you go. Okay.
But, good job. So there's this dude who's at Comic-Con, and he made a Thor's hammer, and you would set it on metallic things. Uh-huh. And so every time somebody touched the hammer, 1 out of 10 chances the magnets would kick off in the hammer. So there was like magnets keeping it to this. And 1 out of 10 times, when somebody touched it, the magnets would kick off so you can actually pick it up. And I thought it was really cool because you just take it around to Comic-Con and stick it to metal things. Be like, are you worthy to wield Thor's hammer? And most people couldn't pick it up because it's like a huge magnet pretty much. And I thought it was funny because, like, the one Deadpool cosplayer comes up and lifts the hammer.
Worthy!
One dude, it was on a sewer grate, and one dude just, like, lifted the sewer grate with it.
Jesus.
It was pretty cool. And then he made, like, kind of a working lightsaber. He made a lightsaber handle, but, like, put a thing where it, like, shot out, I think, propane or something like that.
Mm-hmm.
Not propane, but it would, like, catch on fire, and it was, like, a huge, like, fire thing and be able to, like, burn things with it. But
Kyber crystals.
Yes.
The New Order is using them.
Yeah?
Yeah. That's what Jedis make their lightsabers with, and Siths would use, like, a knockoff version.
Oh, really?
And, like, the Empire never used, like, force weapons and stuff. But in Star Wars 7, there was, like, these missile things that were made with Kyber crystals, which is what Jedis used to make the lightsabers. So the New Order is recognizing the Force and shit. I watched a video. It had, like, a bunch of Easter eggs and stuff. It was really cool.
So, I meant to ask somebody about this, but I thought...
Fucking shit.
So, have you seen the latest film theory about killing Deadpool?
Yeah.
Because Deadpool was about to do this to Wolverine in Daniel Way's stuff, why couldn't you just suffocate Deadpool?
What do you mean?
So, like, wouldn't suffocating kill him?
Probably not. Because suffocation still causes your cells to die.
I guess.
And then when his cells regenerated, they would kick him back into life.
I guess. And then Thanos is like, nope, you ain't dying. Because Thanos loves death, and Deadpool loves death, and a bunch of weird shit. But I don't think that's canon anymore.
Who knows?
I don't know. I don't know what universe that's in. I don't know if it's like Marvel Now, because...
Well, Deadpool is dead in
Marvel Now,
where they...
Yeah, because the planets collide and fucking kill them. But, you know, I'm sure there's been stuff, because I think Deadpool and Thanos came out. And that might be, like... Because I'm not sure if Marvel Now is 616, because that's, like, the main universe, the main Marvel universe.
Mm-hmm.
Man, I like a DC, a fucking Earth 1, Earth 2, Earth 3, and that's about it.
Earth 3.
Yeah.
Earth 3.
Yeah.
Probably going to come into play in The Flash.
Oh, really?
Yeah. Because the last episode of The Flash I watched, fucking Jay, he was the Flash of Earth 2.
Mm-hmm.
But then he ended up at Earth 1, and then they saw the doppelganger in Earth 1, who ended up having a different name because he was adopted. And then Zoom, who was like the villain, who's been around, he was from Earth 2, he's been fucking racing around, he takes off his mask in the episode, and it's fucking Jay. And I'm like, is there an Earth 3?
Because Earth 3, that's where the, I think it's called the Injustice Society is, which is pretty much just, like the evil versions of all the heroes.
Right.
Like, Ultraman. Fuck, hold on. Let me look up all their names. Injustice Society?
Yay.
I think that's them. DC. Maybe it's not.
Injustice League?
Is it the Crime Syndicate? It might be the Crime Syndicate.
Sorry, everybody.
Okay. Crime Syndicate. Yeah, it's the Crime Syndicate. Alright.
Okay. Of America.
Of America. New 52, because they did Forever Evil. Ultraman, Superwoman, Owlman, Johnny Quick, and Power Ring. Deathstorm, and then Sea King, who does not survive the trip to Prime Earth. And then, like, Ultraman is in love with, what was her name? Superwoman, something like that?
Supergirl?
So, yeah, Superwoman. Ultraman and Superwoman, if I remember correctly, were, like, a thing. But, like, she was pregnant with Johnny Quick's kid.
Fucking horse.
Oh! You know how Ultraman gets his power? He crushes kryptonite and, like, fucking sniffs it like cocaine.
That's a badass.
It's pretty great. And then I think... Isn't... One of them's a spy.
One of them's a spy?
Yeah. Atomica... Yeah, who posed as Adam as working for a mole for the Secret Society, yeah. Because, like, it was a story called Forever Evil, and I never finished it. There's a trade of it. I probably should pick it up. But, yeah, a bunch of shit came. They came over, and they were like, we're gonna fucking kill you all.
Nice.
Yeah. So, like, it's weird that, like, based on, like, different stories, how it's just, like, it's just another universe. Because, like, I was reading, I was watching a YouTube video about the Spider-Verse, and how, like, there are so many different universes, like, a bunch of different Spider-Man, and that's all that comic was about, was, like, getting a bunch of Spider-Men together.
Yep.
And then because of the, fuck, what are they called? They're, like, vampires that feed off of Spider-Men. Like, literally, that's what they are. What is
it? Amazing? Ultimate?
Yeah.
Spider-Man.
Superior.
Superior.
Miles Morales.
Yeah.
Which, he's from the Ultimate Universe, right?
I don't know.
No, there was the TV show one that they brought into. There's a giant Tokyo robot Spider-Man. There's Monkey Spider-Man. There's actually, Gwen Stacy becomes Spider-Man.
Yeah.
And in her universe, Peter Parker dies.
Yeah.
Then, there's the one where she's the daughter of Peter Parker and Mary Jane, but they die in a house fire, and she only has a younger brother.
Mm-hmm.
There's one where Uncle Ben survives, and so he just, like, he doesn't want to be Spider-Man anymore because somebody died. I think Aunt May and Peter Parker died, so he didn't want to be Spider-Man anymore. So he just, like, hid out in this bunker. And Dr. Octopus made a bomb and destroyed the entire Earth, and he was, like, the only one who survived. Just a bunch of different fucking, like, alternate realities.
Nice, Doc Ock.
Yeah.
Dick.
Then there was fucking... And it's funny, because 616 Spider-Man saw Superior Spider-Man is like, you're not me. You're Dr. Octopus, aren't you? Like, because that's... I forget how that happens, because, like, that's Superior Spider-Man. It's just like... I'm Dr. Octopus in Spider-Man's body, yeah. I mean, that's all that is. Like, they switch bodies somehow, because I think Doc Ock is dying, so he's like, I'm gonna steal Spider-Man's body, and it was weird.
Nice.
And then, like, there's a chick in the current Marvel Universe called, Silk?
Silk.
She was bitten, because, this was during the, what is it? The Last Sin or something like that? Final Sin? Whatever. And Peter Parker learned that there was somebody else bitten by the same radioactive spider as him. And so she goes and...
They fell in love forever.
Just wait. he goes and finds her, and she's, like, locked in this cell.
Mm-hmm.
And where's actually where they find the bin, where they find Uncle Ben in the other universe. Because, like, he built it. But, so there's a,
okay.
So she's, like, trapped in the cell hiding from, what the fuck are they called? One of the vampire dudes. Like, one of the main vampire dudes.
Dracula.
That, no, they feed
Dracula.
Off, they,
fucking Dracula.
They feed off of,
spider juices.
Spider, yeah, pretty much.
He's got the juiciness.
But, so she was hiding from him, and he was like, oh, I killed him twice. And he was like, wait, you told me he was dead. That means he can come back if you kill him twice. And then they just have sex. Because, like, because there's, like, a weird DNA thing going on that, like, they're pretty much, like, attracted to each other since they were bitten by the same radioactive spider.
Nice.
And so they have, like, they have a really strong...
Come on, meet with me, Morty!
I haven't seen that episode yet.
Oh no.
Oh yeah, no, you're right. That was when he like uses the strong aphrodisiac.
Yeah. Mate with me, Morty.
Right here. Maybe
now.
Maybe we should go somewhere more private. But yeah, no, like because they're bitten by the same spider, they have a really strong sexual relationship. And it seems like that they're gonna be like boyfriend and girlfriend, because I don't know what Mary Jane just like I'm catching up.
Good for you. I'm not. I don't know anything you're talking about. You were all like, it's really fun, man, the other use, because he built it. I'm just like, okay. Fucking the world exploded. Ooh. Yeah.
Did it. There's a bunch of different, like, clones. There's, like, three clones, and it's fucking weird. But, yeah, no, the Spider-Verse is, like, a 30-minute video just explaining that. Then there's, like, a cosmic Spider-Man.
Moving on. Spider-Man is ridiculous.
Yeah. Just like when Civil War came out, like, they were like, oh, all superheroes have to reveal their identities, and Spider-Man was, like, the only person who revealed his identity. So they had to, like, pretty
now,
much...
Now, okay, so is he, like, in the comics, is he, like, an angsty teen? Because that's what he was depicted as in, like, comedy stuff. He's just, like a teen who's just kind of... doping around with the Avengers.
Not really. I don't know. I haven't read a lot of Spider-Man stuff. It doesn't seem like it. Because, yeah, it doesn't seem like it.
What did I watch? I watched something.
Yeah?
I think it was on Netflix. Shit. But, yeah, Spider-Man was pretty funny in it, is all I'm saying.
Yeah, I mean, I guess it depends. Because there was the way they retconned Civil War for Spider-Man, because he was, like, the only person who revealed his identity in that entire story, was, One More Day. It was the One More Day storyline. Everyone hated it. Because it was, like, Aunt May was dying, so, Peter was seeing, like, all the different possibilities he could have had if, like, he wasn't bitten by the spider, if he continues this path, if he continues this one. And so, like, oh, that's what happened to Mary Jane. I remember now. In One More Day... Mephistopheles is like, yeah, I can save old Aunt May if you never, like, if you agree to never love Mary Jane. You'll forget you, like, you won't be married anymore. You, like, won't remember each other, and you can never fall in love again.
And... You know what? Aunt May lived a great life.
You know what Spider-Man says? Yeah, okay. And Aunt May lives. And they just write Mary Jane out.
Oh my god.
And there's like, after he says yes, there's this girl that pops up in the story, like here and there. And Mephistopheles is like, oh yeah, the girl you've been seeing, oh, that's your would-be daughter if you stay with Mary Jane. Have a good life. Like, pretty much that's what happened.
Oh my god.
But that's why people didn't
okay,
like that story.
Okay, any normal person, I'm almost positive, will be like, you know, Aunt May lived a pretty long life. She's
yeah.
pretty old.
Yeah.
And I got a good thing.
Yeah.
I'm in love
yeah.
with this person. What the fuck?
Yeah, that's why people didn't like it.
Oh my god. It's just like... He's like... He fucking says this to him, and Spider-Man's like... Sure. And then he's just stunned.
You're deciding?
Dude, I'm like...
Just like that, you decided?
I'm 90% sure Mary Jane was there with him.
He looks at her.
You can do it.
And then she's like, Peter, what?
And then, wiped.
I mean, like, oh my god, it was totally fucking ridiculous. And there's reasons why people didn't like that.
No fucking
kidding. Because I'm like, wait, if he was falling in love with Silk, why? What happened to Mary Jane? And then I remembered One More Day, and I'm like, oh, that's what happened to Mary Jane.
What the fuck? Well, I'm gonna save my old aunt. I gotta do it. It's like, I know I love you, but I can't do it.
And I think Mary Jane was like, you should do it. You should save Aunt May. Like, I think she was like, you should do it. And I was like, she's so old. Like, she's gonna die in another fucking 10 years anyway.
Or Peter low-key found out that she was pregnant and he couldn't handle the responsibility.
With great power comes great responsibility. And unless it's like, a kid, you fucking duck, like, out so quick.
He's just like, I saw that fucking pregnancy test. This is my out. Oh my god, I can't handle a spider baby. I can't handle a
spider baby. You know, there is a timeline. I think it was a What If comic that Spider-Man does kill Mary Jane with his radioactive semen.
Yep. I remember that. Holy shit, man.
Yeah, a lot of people didn't like One More Day, and I wonder why. Yeah, it was pretty awful. Because I was sitting here, I was like, what the fuck happened to Mary Jane? But, yeah.
She disappeared. Come on. Come on.
They not only did they run, like, pretty much Civil War just, like, disappeared after a while.
Disappear. Disappear.
Like, it didn't even matter in the comics anymore. And, like, so they're like, oh, Spider-Man was, like, the only one affected, and we'll just retcon it with the story. And I was like,
stupid bitch.
Because I guess it was, what the fuck is that called? The Final Sin, or the Final Sin, Marvel? It's,
Mandarvian.
Original Sin.
Original. The original sin was when Eve ate that damn apple.
I mean, I guess. But that's like, somebody kills the Watcher, and what the Watchers are is that they, like, kind of stand outside and they don't intervene with, things, okay. And they just, like, record everything, and somebody kills them and takes his eye.
Oh, Time Lords.
Eh. But, somebody takes
his
eye.
They're not supposed to interfere.
Well, yeah.
That's why Doctor Who is, they're all, like, the Doctor, and then Time Lords are like, you bitch!
Yeah.
Because he interferes.
Yeah. But, but yeah, no, pretty much somebody takes his eye and, like, knows secrets of the Marvel Universe and stuff, and then one of the eyes explodes.
Sorry, just picturing it in my head, and he's like, what is that? We know secrets.
But the other dude who has his eye, he makes it explode, and, like, all these people know, and that's how Peter Parker knew, whatever. And then, like, Thor figured out he had a sister, and, like, a bunch of different stuff like that. And, yeah, it's funny, because, like, I just read Deadpool Kills the Marvel Universe.
Right.
And, like, the Watcher in the very beginning is telling the story of, like, how he's seen a bunch of different, like, timelines and stuff like that. And this one timeline is, like, really unique. And, like, Deadpool just straight up kills a Watcher. And, like, the Watcher's like, how did you know I was here? And I was like, because I'm fucking Deadpool.
It's like, you know how I know things, bitch?
So, the thing about Deadpool is, like, knowing...
Because I'm watching you, watching me, watching you, watching me, bitch! <'Cause>...
But, Deadpool, no one can read his mind.
Oh.
Because of, like, the way his, like, healing factor works, it's really weird. Like, no one can read his mind. And the fact...
That's really well explained.
No, it's weird. It's not even well explained in the comics.
I know.
But,
that's what I'm jabbing at.
like,
even... Oh, he can heal... No mind read for him.
Even, like, Beast tries to explain it. But, like, he's like, reasons... But, so...
They just didn't want anyone to be able to read his mind.
Yeah, no, so, like... Deadpool gets a new voice.
Mm-hmm.
Like, the two other voices, like, go away. And he gets this red text box voice... And pretty much the way that Deadpool Kills the Marvel Universe happens is, like, it's mainly, like, in a weird way, it's our fault. Because he's, like,
they're just, like, the reason he kills them is to let them out of their misery, because, like, he, like, knows that, like, he's in a comic book and they're just there for entertainment, so he just kills them to get rid of them. And, like, even is fighting Wolverine at this point. He's like, the reason you keep coming back is not because of your healing factor, it's your popularity. And, like, he just gets really meta. But there's this one moment where, like, he's talking to Professor Xavier. He has a Professor Xavier hostage so he can kill all the X-Men, because he knows that they'll try to come save him. And so he's, like, talking, and he's like, you never let me join the X-Men. You never understood. You just thought I was a lunatic. And
sounds like you went a little crazy.
Yeah, no, he does. And, like, Charles Xavier, like, the strongest telepath in, like, all of the Marvel Universe, pretty much. The red voice is like, let him look into your mind. And, like, Charles Xavier looks into Deadpool's mind, and he says, oh, I understand now. And he goes brain dead from all the information, like, within Deadpool's head. Like, he couldn't, like, stand, like, he was a comic book character. Like, since he read Deadpool's mind, he knew, like, he finally understood, and then he went fucking brain dead from it.
That's fucking awesome. Come on.
I know.
Holy shit.
Like, hold on, I can fucking show you it.
I want to see.
Deadpool of the Marvel Universe. Oh. Wolverine. Yeah. I'm going to make sure you never... Oh, I never realized. And he starts crying and bleeding from the nose, and he goes fucking brain dead.
That's awesome.
Yeah.
Well, they can't read his mind, because if they did, they'd know it was fucking fourth wall shit.
Yeah.
And then they'd be like...
It's too much, like, information for their brain to handle.
They'd be like, what? What the fuck is my life? That's some serious shit, dude.
I know.
So it's like, you're just reading this comic book. It's like, yay, comics. And then you find this one.
Yeah.
And you're going through it, and it's all like,
wait, you're killed. They can't. What have I done?
Yeah. And there's, like, a point where Deadpool, like, the final fight is with Taskmaster, which I thought was really cool. Because Taskmaster, do you know who Taskmaster is?
Yeah.
He has, like, the photogenic, photographic memory. Or he has photographic reflexes, because after you see somebody fight, you can copy their style perfectly. But, since Taskmaster can copy anyone, he starts copying Deadpool after a while, because his reflexes start kicking in. And to the point where Taskmaster can hear the new voice in Deadpool's mind. It was weird. And then, like, it's not Swamp Thing. It's another thing. Opens, like, kills Taskmaster, and he kills this thing, and it opens up, like, a portal to all the different multiverses. In the very end of Deadpool Kills the Marvel Universe, is Deadpool coming to our world to kill the writers. And he's like, after a while, I'll be done here, and I'm coming for you next.
That's awesome.
Yeah, I mean, just like, Deadpool Kills the Marvel Universe, if you want a really, really fucking meta and brutal Deadpool comic, go with that one, because, like, that's just the most meta. And there's awesome. It's awesome because there's this one scene where Deadpool steals Pym particles, which is Ant-Man. Mm-hmm. Not
yeah,
Ant-Man.
That's what the
and that's what he uses to, like, shrink and stuff.
Mm-hmm.
And so Deadpool shrinks just like a shit ton of bombs in, like, where the Avengers are hiding. And, like, I think Pym, like, Ant-Man comes in, and it's like all the Pym particles are stolen. And Wolverine's like, I know who he's coming after next. And, like, you just see all these bombs show up. And it's like, it's nice. It's us. And then, like,
Here's a nuke. Everywhere a nuke.
Yeah. And then, like, I think Luke Cage survives, and Thor. But yeah, they're just sitting here, and then, like, a bunch of fucking bombs show up, and then kaboom. Then, yeah, Thor's throwing his hammer at Deadpool, and so, like, as it's coming back, Deadpool just, like, makes it really big, and it crushes Thor. So Deadpool waits until Hulk turns into Bruce Banner, cuts his head off. The way he kills Luke Cage, because Luke Cage has, like, unbreakable skin, mm-hmm. is that he uses more pimp particles, hides bombs in the coffee they were drinking, and blows them up with inside Luke Cage.
This is ridiculous. Fucking hell, man.
Oh, it's awesome. Deadpool's, like, my favorite character now. But, yeah, it's, like, a really meta, because he's just, like, trying to save them. He just straight up fucking blows Spider-Man's head off.
Well, yeah, I mean... what is Spider-Man gonna do against Deadpool?
Yeah, and it's like... he's like... I think he, like, loses his fingers or something like that. No, this is a different one. Like,
ooh, get webs cut.
No, that's a Daniel Webb, or Daniel Webb. Daniel Way, comic I'm thinking of. But, there's, like, he's, like, talking about, like, Spider-Man's, like, you won't beat the crap out of me. I'm just gonna take you to wherever. And, Deadpool's like, you're right, I won't beat the crap out of you. I'll just shoot you, and just fucking blows his head off. It's like, no wonder the villains couldn't... Did your villains ever try a gun on you or something like that? Oh, it was so great. He fucking kills a lot of people in this, obviously. Because, like, Charles Xavier, like, has him, put in a mental institute. And that's what kind of, like, starts everything. Because somebody gets rid of the other two voices in his head. And so this one shows up in place of them. Kills a bunch of the X-Men. Oh, yeah, he wraps this thing around Cyclops' head. And Cyclops starts to, like, shoot it off. But it pretty much makes, like, a really small explosion killing everyone around him.
What about Colossus?
Colossus gets shocked to death along with the other two people he's with. Which is Gambit wow. and... I guess Rogue? That's Rogue. Magneto, fucking just like acid. And then the chick who can go through walls, I can't think. Cat, I think that's her name. But like he puts him in like a cube that she can never get out of because it's just like made of a bunch of mirrors. She wears Beast skin as he kills Deadpool or kills Wolverine.
How does he kill Wolverine?
Chops his fucking head off.
Is it?
Yep. Yeah. Your tendency to come back from the brink of death has nothing to do with your healing factor. Your mutant power isn't regeneration. It's popularity. But don't worry. I've got big plans and all the popularity in the world can't save you this time. Cuts his head off.
Well, okay.
Kills Doctor Strange.
Wouldn't be enough. But yeah, that's cool.
Fucking... Oh yeah, like all like most of like the heroes and villains have a fucking like suicide pact. Punisher tries to kill him, and it's like a dummy. And like, I guess it's Puppet Master, which I don't know who Puppet. Oh, I guess Puppet Master. I guess like Deadpool hires him. I guess he can make like voodoo dolls of people, and that's why people are committing mass suicide and shit. And so he has like a little thing of the Punisher, and fucking blows the Punisher's head off. I think even the back said, like, this isn't your regular Deadpool story. Well, if everything you thought was funny about Deadpool was actually just disturbing, what if he decided to kill everyone off and everything that makes up the Marvel Universe? And what if he actually pulled it off? Would that be fun for you? The Merc with the Mouth takes a turn for the twisted as he puts every Marvel hero in the crosshairs in a horror comic like no other. You know there's a thing called Marvel Zombies? It's like one of the most ridiculous stories, because, I'll just leave it at this. The Marvel Zombies end up eating Silver Surfer, so they get galactic powers, and then Galactus comes, and they eventually eat Galactus, and they become Galactus themselves, so there's, like, a bunch of Marvel Zombies, like, roaming the universe, eating everything they can.
So, yeah. Why did they eat Silver Surfer?
Because Silver Surfer he was food to them.
To who?
All of the Marvel heroes that were still alive that were turned into zombies.
Why were they turned into zombies?
Some virus that really never kind of explains. It's just like, so Reed Richards of the Ultimate Universe is just becoming a hero, so he gets a call from another universe saying like, oh, come here and I'll teach you how to be a hero, and it's Reed Richards from another universe, which is Mr. Fantastic for anyone who doesn't know.
Oh, yes.
And so he builds this portal to go to this universe, but it turns out, like, it was a big ruse by the zombies. And so, like, all the zombie...
By zombies.
Because, like, they're still intelligent after they eat. Like, they gain some sanity. But, so, they trap the Fantastic Four zombies within the Ultimate Universe in a room. And that's for the last time I know, and they're still there. Locked in a basement somewhere. But, so, yeah, like, the only, like, survivor of that world is Magneto with a bunch of people, and Reed Richards makes it back, but they're just old zombies. It's just, like, a outbreak that started out, and the Marvel, like, Marvel heroes turned into zombies, but since they had superpowers, they killed everyone and ate everyone on the planet, pretty much. And the reason they wanted to bring Reed Richards to make the portal is because they ran out of food, and they want to go to different universes eating people.
Not on board.
It was pretty interesting. I just saw, like, a YouTube video on it.
Alright. Anything else you want to talk about?
I don't know. I wanted to talk about the SAO game a little bit.
I don't know anything about it. I haven't seen a video
that
you're talking about.
It's just pretty much it shows kind of, like, some concept art, like, 3D models and stuff like that. And, it's just pretty much an SAO game coming to actual virtual reality.
Well, if it's amazing, it's fucking good.
Yeah.
I will do it no matter what. Risk of death? I'm there.
I need to rewatch SAO. Eventually.
I did, not that long ago.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I only watched it once. I didn't watch SAO 2. I really liked SAO 2. I like Gun Gale.
Really? Yeah. Gun Gale.
Everything after it was okay.
People were not too satisfied with the second season.
I don't know. I thought Gun Gale, and then they did the Excalibur story, which was okay, and then they brought all the stuff with the Yuki, which I really liked.
Fuck. I'm just telling you that...
Yeah.
Most of the general population were not on board with it.
Yeah. And I can see why it's different.
But I have seen a lot of hype for some new characters in the third season from whatever Marvel stuff.
Yeah.
So I'm just sitting, like, people have been like, oh, these characters, and I'm like, you told me their names. No idea who they are.
But yeah, no, like, Yukiko, like, no, not Yukiko, that's a Persona 4 character. Yuki. That's what her name was, right? It was like this cool character, like, she was a total badass, like,
dying.
Yeah. AIDS. I mean, like, and then it was, like, so emotional, because, like, and then, like,
ooh.
And then, like, Asuna at the time was, like, her mom was just, like, fucking, you're not, fuck the game, you're not going to that school anymore.
Yeah.
And it's like, I'll never see fucking Kirito again. And, like, it was just so emotional. It was like a fucking emotional roller coaster.
Mom is super bitch.
Yeah. And then, like, fucking Asuna brings her mom into the virtual world, and her mom starts crying, and she has second thoughts, and, oh, it was so beautiful. And then it was like... And it was, like, the very ending scene where, like, Yuki is dying and Asuna's there with her. And I was like, you know what? It's just the two. I'm not going to cry. And then, like, everyone else shows up. I'm like, God damn it.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, fuck.
You can talk about crying. You just need to watch it Kamui Got Killed.
Oh, really? Somebody brought up Angel Beats the other day.
That's emotional too.
I never finished it. I started watching it. Now that I have, the thing is, it's like animes I started watching on Hulu, like the ads like really kind of put me off. But now since I have like ad free Hulu, I definitely want to go back and watch some of it.
Watch Angel Beats and The Kamui Ga Kill and whatever else you haven't finished.
Okay, this is what I'll do. I'm gonna go through. I'll watch Angel Beats.
Yes.
Because that's like a season.
Yeah, it's pretty short.
Then I'll do Seraph of the End. Because I started that, and I kind of want to finish it. I was going to wait until the second season finished up so I can just watch it all.
It's quite good.
Yeah. From what I saw, I really enjoyed it. And then I'll watch Akame Ga Kill.
Yes. You must feel my pain.
I wanted to watch One Punch Man, but fucking Hulu has no subtitles.
I know. Hulu's being retarded.
Yeah, and Maya, my friend Maya, or I guess our friend Maya, said that, fucking, it was like, I watched it on Hulu, and it was fine. I'm like, well, it's not fine on mine.
One Punch Man is amazing.
Yeah, it seems cool. I mean, I've heard really good things from a lot of people, so...
It is really good. And it ends on a pretty good note, too.
Does it?
Because the last thing of it is he actually ends up fighting an enemy that he can't defeat in one punch.
Oh, yeah. You're telling me about that. I think we were talking about that during our Devil May Cry 3 Let's Play.
And I'm just like, oh, yes. It's really good.
So I was kind of thinking of Persona because they have Persona 4 anime and they have Persona 4 Golden, which is also another anime. But it's weird because I thought to myself, like, I've played every single Persona 4 game besides Persona 4. I played Persona 4 Arena, I played Persona 4 Ultimax, and I'm playing Persona 4 Dancing All Night right now.
Dancing All Night.
Dancing All Night is canon, and I fucking love it. Because it's like, because I guess this dead idol, like, controls the Shadow World. It's called the Midnight Stage. And it was like, oh, you, there's no violence here. You have to dance your way out.
You must dance.
Like, dancing is the only way to kill shadows in this world. And I'm like, yes. Oh, it's so great. It's like one of the funnest rhythm games I've ever played. But yeah, so we're coming up on an hour.
That's been a while.
Yeah, I was aiming for an hour tonight since we didn't have one last night, or last Friday.
Right, because, you know, the last week I thought you were going to text me.
Yeah.
I actually expected it, and then I was like, fuck it.
Well, I texted you, we couldn't meet today.
Right, well, I thought you were going to talk, like, another day or something.
Well, the only reason we couldn't meet up, because my dad's car got repoed in the middle of the night.
Nice. That's awesome.
That's why we have that Crown Victoria.
Get fucked.
And, yeah, so that was a bunch of bullshit. And then, like, my grandma that night had to come out with a different car that we could use, and that's why we have two cars out in the driveway. But, yeah, so I'm going to wrap it up. We're going to wrap it up. It's getting close to an hour. I'll probably take Alex home soon. So, yeah, this has been the podcast No One Gave a Crap About. I'm Thais.
And I'm Alex.
And we'll see you guys in whatever we make. Woo! Hour! Fuck you! Fucking!
That's the end! Fuck you, bitches! That's the end! Woo!
I wonder how many people get that reference. Hopefully all of you. Alright. Oh, also, whoever made it to the end of this, thanks for 40 subscribers. You guys are awesome.
Yeah, I saw that.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Fucking... Yeah, but cool. See you guys.
Bye. Bye, everybody.